Because of Jenson Button and Takuma Sato, the BARs will not be allowed to race here, or indeed in a couple of weeks' time in Monte Carlo. Suddenly, their season has turned very sour.
This was meant to be a great weekend for BAR. The car is fast, and Jensen's at the top of his form. But now the team have pulled out, and rather than driving at 200 miles an hour, Jenson Button and Takuma Sato have been in hiding. It's crushed the spirits of everyone in the team. The controversy is all about whether BAR used fuel as ballast. Their designers saw a grey area in the rules and took advantage of it. As they told the FIA courtroom, the rule on weight says the car must never run less kilos, but it does not specify whether that's to be measured with or without fuel. BAR thought it could be with fuel. Their dry weight was 594 kilos. So even though with fuel the car was always over the minimum, it was possible for them to run underweight. Was Jensen aware of this?
I'm not going to know everything about the car, and obviously now everybody knows every detail about our car, so I know as much as everybody else. But apart from that, I don't really want to comment too much on it. A two-race ban, it's mad. You know, it's all these guys that have worked in there non-stop to build this car, and back at the factory at BAR and Honda, bringing this car here, hoping for a fantastic weekend. Suddenly we're sat here doing nothing.
And you're saying that BAR have been deliberately breaking the rules, cheating?
Effectively, yes. That's what one has to say. In our view, they knew what they were doing, they knew the advantages it would bring, and they did it notwithstanding that, and it destroys the whole basis of Formula One. We've got these people fighting for a hundredth of a second, and if you've got a device like this, it just subverts the entire competition. It destroys the basis of a competition if you do things like that.
The FIA have very nicely reduced their claim of fraud and deception, and it's now become lack of transparency, which is good, we acknowledge that. But on the other hand, the severity of the penalty still makes it look as though we're guilty, which we're not.
Nevertheless, the other teams regard BAR's interpretation of the weight rule as nonsense. Many believe it gave them an unfair advantage.
I think it's pretty clear how your car needs to be weighed, and you can't do that with fuel in it, so for me it's pretty clear cut.
Very difficult to believe that they've done anything knowingly to you know, get around the rules. It's clearly just an interpretation thing.
From what I've heard, I'm not really in the position because I'm only a bloody driver, but when the technical guys say what they've done, it's a very old trick.
In the sport, everything is not legal, you need to pay. And for sure they are paying for that.
It's harsh, but I think you need to set a standard to really show people they shouldn't go that route. Because if they make a lag, you know, if they just take the points away from one race, people, you know, everybody starts thinking, oh, we should do that.
Honda are one of the manufacturers unhappy with the way F1 is run and have threatened to establish a breakaway series. Journalist Michael Schmidt was with us in the FIA court in Paris, and he believes there's a link here.
The FIA and Max were hoping that this case against BAR Honda would bring Honda back in the FIA camp. But I think the outcome is a completely different one. Honda now will have even less trust in the FIA because they think that the judgment is far too harsh for what they did.
And one thing that Japanese hate is dishonesty. You know, in Japanese business, we don't, you know, I mean, sometimes we don't need a contract. We just need to shake hands. And, you know, I mean, people like to think that Honda didn't do it intentionally.
I'm sure that the senior management at Honda had no idea this was going on. No way they would allow that to happen. Why risk the reputation of your company? Now, this was done by the engineers at team level and kept very quiet, I'm sure, from everybody.
Jenson Button has a Williams option for next year. But what effect will this embarrassment have on his future?
Yeah, it's not going to change anything for me for the future. It's not going to damage my career. And it's not going to make me choose where I want to be for the future either. We expected to come here and have a very good chance of getting a podium and maybe a win. And Monaco, I thought we were going to destroy the opposition in Monaco. So that's why it's really disappointing for the whole team and especially me.
Tony, loads of British fans are here in Barcelona. I spoke to a few of them. Their faces fell this morning, and I confirmed to them Jensen will not be racing here or in Monaco.
Well, imagine if it happened to Alonso here, or if it happened to Button at Silverstone, the same effect. It is pretty devastating for the whole team, and particularly Button. The car's been going so well, Jim. Mugello is really fast. It set an unofficial lap record here in Barcelona, and all that's being squandered, really. It's a great shame, and I think the fans are being deprived.
The way he was talking there, he fancied himself for a win in Monaco, didn't he?
Well, he did. He was very, very close last year. He was superb. You remember 3 years ago, he had that big smash, and last year he very nearly did it and caught Trulli up at the end.
What about his future? Surely the time is ticking now. He'll be on his way out of BAR at the end of the season, won't he?
Well, I think it's very difficult. He's waving goodbye to any chance of the World Championship now. By August, he's got to have three quarters of the points of the leader in the championship. There's no way he's going to do that, and Williams can take up the option. So I think he's going to have a big job to try and keep this fella in BAR.
Okay, Tony, thank you very much indeed. All it means as well is the result of the San Marino Grand Prix has been changed. Alexander Wurz claiming Button's trophy. He's promoted to third. Sato's